working on this painting project all week. The Magical Brother 2016 Sublime with Rome and Dirty Head with Friends Summer Tour.
This is the ad mat. It's going to be used for posters and a special Magical Butter machine, limited edition, and some other stuff.
Yeah, so if you look, I'm putting all the detail in on the Octopus. And it's kind of taking a little bit longer than I expected. I worked really late last night. Felt the earthquake out here in California. Rattled for about 20 seconds. And so it's coming together, but I still have probably a full day working on it. And if you look at all the little happy flowers, and it's starting to pop. And Sublime guys over there are looking pretty cool. And then you can see all the other little...
Rome's got a cookie in his mouth. Eric's enjoying a little something. Josh Free's banging on the drums.
Look at this over here. Mr. Butter up there.
Magical Butter Bus. Woo-hoo.
So yeah, for those of you who've seen the project all week, you can see how it's really starting to tighten up. And hopefully this afternoon I'll have all this black line done and all the detail, and then we can get it photographed and build all the things that it's going to be in the computer. And it takes all these components to make these things cool. They can go together in lots of different ways. And that way it can be used for like buses and tickets and t-shirts and pretty much anything that we can imagine. And it's really fun. It's coming out great. Just sometimes things are just so much fun to draw, and this was one of them, making all these little happy guys. And
happy guys.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Blacklining.
Hey, you want me to see me blacklining? So you can see this area here, I haven't blacklined yet, but you can watch and see how this like really pops. You can see what a slow process this is. A lot of people hire me to do things and they say, yeah, can you just do this real quick? And I'm like, nothing good happens real quick. So if you end up getting one of these t-shirts or posters one day, you'll realize like all the hard work that went into it. And you're just seeing the painting. Half the hard work was doing the sketching, coming up with the ideas and, you know, listening to the music, all the different people's input. And then taking all that and creating what you see here. I like how everything's dripping this butter. It'd be hard to hang on to that guitar with butter all over you. You see how I make this look like it's dripping? One of the things about this this stage that makes it really good for the artist out there is you notice I got a fat black, a medium black, and a thin black. So what makes it really cool is thick and thin lines. So that really gives it depth, and that can be really thick and really thin. And some combination of that is really what makes it more dynamic. You don't want to have like one size line. You want a variance that makes it seem like something's closer or further away. At this point, not trying real hard. This is almost just like routine for me. even the coloring process is pretty routine. It's all the hard work is done in the sketching. And then from there I can see it done in my mind. The strings on the guitar last. It'll be just like little white lines. And that's a whole nother step. So after I finish all this black line, I do all the highlights with white. And that's when it really pops. It's just crazy how many like little steps. I don't know how many of you have ever seen my video. My video is kind of old now. It's probably like 10 years old. I really show how this methodical type of painting with the paint pens can make it really easy. And you know, you don't have to worry about the whole thing at once. And then you can do the thick and thin lines and then pop it with all the highlights, and it's just makes any painting go from good to great. And the Posca pens are what really allows you to do this. It's just a real unintimidating way to paint. And you can do it sitting anywhere, not make a mess. It's great. The art stores have those little miniature, you know, Fredrix canvases now. And you can buy a bunch of those and do a whole bunch of like little paintings and get your ideas out. Tentacles are what's taking so long in here. You know, there's just a lot of little bubbles and tentacles and veins and dripping butter. And see, I can even add stuff. So see right here with the green. The pens are opaque enough that I can kind of add more. I want to make it the guitar look like it's dripping. Let that dry, and then I'm going to go over here.
Feel free to ask in the comments. Anne wants to know, why is Posca your favorite? Have you tried other paint pens?
Posca is my favorite. Number one, they're the oldest. These pens came out in the mid 80s, and I got my hands on them probably in the late 80s. And their colors are really good. They blend really well. They don't make mud. Something about the consistency of the colors and the consistency of the paint. It just goes on real smooth. It's really opaque. I have tried lots of the other pens that have been coming out in the last few years, and they're all good. Some of them have great colors, but what I've noticed is a lot of them get thin and transparent. The inks coagulate, and as soon as it does that, the pen's ruined, you know. It just doesn't work anymore. And so, for whatever reason, Posca seemed to have it figured out, and nobody else seems to figure out how to make them so that the ink stays the right consistency and doesn't thicken, but it also doesn't thin. So that makes for a nice, smooth color transitions. They're a little bit difficult to get, but Posca assures me that they're going to be much more available in the next 6 months. So we look forward to that. We work with them pretty close to try to get these in the hands of artists all around the world. So, there it is.
Hey, our friend from Italy says, kisses from Italy, Ohana Print is here now, thanks.
All right.
Good to have you on the line. Glad you like your print.
Yeah, the Ohana Print is amazing. We did that for the Ohana Festival happening in Dana Point, and Eddie Vedder of Pearl Jam commissioned it, put that together. And it's going to be a really great concert festival right on the beach here in Doheny at Dana Point, California. And all the proceeds are, maybe not all of them, but they're raising money for the state park systems, specifically Doheny and San Onofre, which are the big surfing beaches here in our community. So hats off to Kelly Slater and Eddie Vedder for making that happen.
Okay, Jamie Randolph wants to know if you had any formal schooling.
No, I have not. I kind of in art school, or not art school, but in high school, I had a great art teacher, Cheryl Todd, and I'm not sure she knew what to do with me, but she let me take art all 4 years, and it was really great for me because, you know, it just allowed me to do what I was good at. And I actually got accepted to a lot of great art colleges, but for whatever reason, couldn't make that happen. So instead, I just went and surfed, moved to Hawaii, and painted surfboards. And everything seemed to work out just fine. So high school art training was about it. Thanks, Cheryl Todd, for always believing in me.
Good to have somebody believe in you, right?
Yeah.
Nick's asking, is the black a different fino tip?
No, they're basically, I'll show you all the sizes. You have a really fat one, medium, thin. And so, and there's actually one thinner than this, but I don't use it. So that's about it that I need. Yeah, so they're different sizes.
What kind of varnish do you use?
I'll spray this with a matte of Krylon acrylic clear, and then I'll varnish it with Liquitex, usually a satin finish Liquitex varnish, and brush it on.
How durable is Posca?
It's great. We've used it on surfboards for years. I have surfboards that painted 25 years ago that still look beautiful. Sun can't damage almost anything, so if you leave something in the sun, all bets are off. But for the most part, things I painted 20, 25 years ago still look like this. So pretty durable. And then with all the UV protectant, clears and things you can put on things these days, I'm pretty confident that, the paint's gonna hold up for, 20, 50, 100 years. Well, that time will tell, right?
So Roger is from Brazil and he wants a shout out.
Right on, Roger. Life is good down in Brazil. Hope you're catching some waves.
So Zach's asking, do they stay on the surfboard once you get it wet? It's a great question. We get this question all the time.
After you paint it, we put Krylon acrylic clear on it, or sometimes like automotive urethane, so that locks in the paint. If you didn't put a clear on it, it would come off pretty quick. It is a water-based pen. You can see how this detail just really makes it pop and separates everything. And I'm going to give you a quick little look at how the white will look. So you imagine, just little highlights of white. And I'm going to do that all over too.
Nick's asking, ink or acrylic? It's just like a water-based opaque.
I don't think it's an acrylic. I think it's more like some type of tempera type of solution, almost like an ink. But Posca really doesn't say, and doesn't claim, it doesn't say acrylic or anything on it.
It's like a water-based opaque paint.
It's has a really weird consistency. And Posca is it's a Mitsubishi pencil company. And so I didn't know this, but the people from the company, when I met them, Mitsubishi Pencil Company is the oldest writing instrument manufacturer in the world. They've been making things to write with for, some like 400 years or something.
That's crazy.
So I guess they figured out how to make things to write with.
That's a good song. I'm gonna show everybody what you drive to work every day. Just for a little break. There's Drew's van.
Yeah, we did the van with spray paint. So I think there's a video online you can watch the van being painted. Spray paint, a little bit of airbrush.
So Brent Betchell has a great question. Brent, I love this question. It is, what thoughts do you have when you see your early work that you did years ago? Does it take you back to that time period?
Yeah, it hasn't changed that much. It's just, it's gotten better. I haven't lost that kid in me. So I really like that I'm still pretty loose and still making it fun. But, I look at some of the old stuff and it seems a bit rushed. and that was because I was having to paint 10 to 20 surfboards a day. And you weren't really getting paid to make it perfect. You were getting paid to make it look cool. And, you know, kind of to that earlier question, did I go to school, is no. But, you know, just that repetition of painting every day under a timeline really allowed me to refine my technique. So now that I'm older and I get these bigger jobs, I can spend the time on them to make them really good. And yeah, so the earlier stuff is still cool, it's just not as refined.
So Zach wants to know, what do we call the van? We call it the Dream Machine. And it says it on the back, but you can't see it from this far away. The Dream Machine. Trev wants to know, can you paint even when you're not feeling it?
Yeah, being a professional illustrator, artist, I pretty much paint every day. So it's not an option to feel unmotivated. But sometimes it's harder than other times, like being able to really let it flow. A lot of times I gotta listen to people and what they want, and you know, I'm not really feeling it, so it takes a little bit of work mentally to tap into whatever our clients are wanting from me. So it's not an option not to feel it, you know, you gotta do things. So I'll take a walk, or I'll listen to music, or I'll play my guitar. I have a guitar here that I turn up and I'll let it rip. So yeah, there's things that you can do to motivate yourself, and I do that a lot.
Monica says she's about to paint her first mural, never painted on such a big scale. What's your advice?
The murals, the design is important. Make sure you get it on there accurately. I use a grid pattern. I make a map and I'll grid it out like 1 inch to 1 foot. And then don't try to paint the whole thing at once, you know, try to do it in sections. And kind of like I do this, you know, like I get it all drawn in there, I put all the base colors and just move around with the color palette. And that way, take the enormity out of it. You know, you're just filling in colors and then you can detail from there. Put your music on and have fun with it.
Robert wants to know, what do you think about people doing the same thing you do?
I think it's awesome because, you know, when I started painting with paint pens, I really envisioned that every surf shop should have like a local kid painting the local flavor on the local surfboards, and each surf shop kind of having its own identity, even within a town. And it can support an artist like me. I was really lucky that my surf community in South Carolina took me in and you know, allowed me to do what I was good at. And I want that for all the people out there. You know, and the paint pens are a great way to do it. I love seeing what people create. And sometimes if they're practicing, you know, copying one of my things, that's pretty cool. It's like humbling and flattery. So yeah, go out there and paint stuff.
CJ Dornberger says, great job at Lulu's Cafe, by the way.
Thanks. Yeah, that was the biggest mural I've ever painted. That was 60 feet by like 20 feet or?
No, 32.
Yeah.
32 feet.
Yeah, I can't remember. All I know is I was up and down that scaffolding. It was like being a monkey on monkey bars. And, you know, the painting part of it was taxing enough, but what was really, what you, you know, if being outside, what you got to take into consideration is the weather. I was right in the direct sunlight. It was like over, you know, 90 degrees every day. So in the direct sunlight, I was probably just getting cooked. And that was something I really prepared for, that heat. But I got it done. I was doing a mural at the Pipe Masters in Hawaii one year, and it rained the whole time. So that was the other extreme. The paint was literally dripping off the walls as I painted it. And I was about to cry. I was like, oh my gosh. But I just kept going and act like everything was fine, and eventually I got it done.
Anna wants to know, how do you stop yourself from getting hand cramps from drawing every day?
Yeah, that's a good question. You know, it's these micro movements, so right here tends to hurt, and sometimes my shoulder. I surf a lot, so that motion is good, and then paddleboard. So, you know, I got really strong arms, so my wife massages them. But I have had to go to professional masseuses to work on my hands and arms due to overuse.
Marcio Cau, or I'm not sure how to pronounce the last name, C-A-U, says, this is good. How are you, Drew? I worked on Lost Brazil in 2003. You made a 2 meter by 3.3 meter panel to the office.
Oh, yeah.
Do you remember? It was incredible. I'm inspired by your art every day. I'm a friend of Matt Biolis. I know San Clemente. Love the town.
Right on. Yeah, nice to meet you. Yeah, that was really fun down in Brazil, painting and doing the mural for the office. And I think it was a bunch of fish looking at a little Saturn, and yeah, it was cool. I'm glad to hear it's still down there, and yeah, come visit when you're in San Clemente. Matt's right down the street. I think he just drove by.
Trey Cotton is asking, do you clear coat your paintings before you outline it?
Sometimes I do, actually. I didn't do it on these, usually because they get kind of smelly, and my wife doesn't like the smell, but it is good when you put the matte finish on there. It pops the colors, and you know, you kind of have a better idea how it's going to end up. But I've been doing it long enough now that I know what the colors are going to do. So this is where the thin lines come in. So I've already got a lot of thick lines, but this is going to be like kind of the veins in the octopus's head. And I'm doing them really thin. And I can weight it. I always say weighting it, like make it thicker on the bottom like this, and then have it thinner on the top. And that'll give the impression of, you know, it being thicker. And have some dimension to it.
Jamie Rudolph wants to know, other than paint pens, do you use other methods? Yes. As you can see in these paintings, combination of many different mediums all together.
The different mediums, I was an airbrusher at first. I grew up, you know, learning how to use the airbrush gun in order to paint surfboards. So I think it's good to master all the different techniques. I always say one day I'm going to learn how to paint with oils. And I actually started that process. But, you know, at this stage of my career, these illustrations need to be done quickly, and sometimes this is the best way for me to get these ideas out and finished. they're not paying you to create a masterpiece, they're paying you to create an idea that is going to help articulate their message, and it just needs to be done.
Colleen Milligan says, hey, I'm just getting a performance painting, visiting bands here in Florida. I think I found them using your work. These pens seem to be so useful versus getting paint everywhere. Yeah, that is so true. Like, these are so easy and portable, and you can, you know, they're non-toxic, no mess. They're perfect for live painting, and you can paint really fast. She also says, shout out to Magical Butter Guys. They have some of her work and speak highly of you.
Awesome. Yeah, good luck painting live. It's a lot of fun, and I think paint pens are good for all the detail stuff, and then, you know, being able to utilize other paints to fill in color. But right on.
Shane wants to know what you're painting on. It's a canvas. So it's a Fredrix canvas. So you can see. Yeah, so it can be hung on the wall and sold as an original painting.
I like painting on the gallery wrap so it doesn't have to be framed. Octopus has had a little too much butter. He looks crazy. I hope the boys with the dirty heads like the octopus. I haven't heard any word back, but I don't know. I think it's pretty cool. I think they'll like it.
Jamie wants to know where to buy the paint pens. You can get them online. There's a lot of places online, but you can go to Amazon.com or you can go to DurableSupply.com. They actually have some pretty good deals, and they're nice people. We know them personally.
Tentacle wrapping around this spoon. I think this painting is one of the funner paintings I've done in a long time.
That's why I was having so much fun with it.
Yeah, I mean,
thank you, Magical Butter, for making this.
I mean, like, all these guys aren't done yet, but just seeing all the life and when all this goes into one piece, I mean, you'll just trip out on this just looking at it. That's what I've been doing, painting, just laughing.
Justin wants to know if you ever get artist block, and if so, how do you overcome it?
It kind of goes back to the last question of, if I'm not feeling it, I usually play my guitar, go surfing, go out into nature, listen to music, and it all comes back. Tap into the universe. sounds even sick. I'd like to know like how many hours I have into all these pieces, and you know, kind of quantify how long I've been sitting here and how much energy went into painting this. It's pretty much been all week with you know, breaks and meetings and working on some other projects, but in the back room I have a couple other projects I'm working on that it's always, I'm bouncing from one room to another here. A lot of times you gotta let the paint dry on one to kind of go to the next one.
Do you miss airbrushing?
I don't miss the more technical just stuff of just painting colors or fades. With the fine art paintings, I do a lot of hand cut out stencils for each piece, and so that's pretty cool. And then, you know, I still have all those skills. Unfortunately, a lot of people don't have them. You know, nobody's learning how to do some of the more intricate stuff that I know how to do. And so I get a lot of requests to paint things like, you know, that board's all airbrushed. I turned it around on you guys. So back in the early Lost days, I trained a whole lot of guys to paint surfboards with me, and this one kid who was really good, Sean Spoto, he was a great artist, and I'd tell him there was a phone call for him up front. He'd go answer the phone, and I'd turn a surfboard around that he was working on, and he'd come back to it, and he didn't know what changed. And I did it to him all the time. It's so mean. He'd come back and just look at it like, what was I doing? Hadn't seen Sean in a long time. I hope you're doing well, man. All right, let's pop one of these little guys. It helps for all the artists out there. I mean, there's times where I'm like really tight and I'm trying to get a smooth line, like here, where I'm locking everything. And then there's other times where I'm like really loose, like where I'm just kind of like letting the pen just kind of meander around. It's just important to be loose as it is to be tight, you know? To get a nice smooth arc is really good. But not everything has to be smooth. give it that organic look, kind of is a loose. You can see I'm barely holding the pen. Just kind of, and it creates the little bit more fun effect. And I'll come back to those and I'll have like little green dots in there. Let's do one of these notes. So these are like fun little musical notes. It's funny, this whole painting and pretty much most of my paintings, everything looks alive. Including the musical notes. Imagine music going through the air and it's like alive. That vibration.
Can't really get that from computer art.
Like a little dancing sound particle. So you see this like random yellow lines there. You know, that was a mistake, so I'm not going to worry about it. I'll just paint over it with white. People always ask about making mistakes, and it's not so much that you make mistakes, it's that you're only as good as fixing the mistakes, you know, or the things that you don't like. So as long as you're not letting stuff slide, you're doing good. But like, no matter what you're doing, art or anything else, is, you know, you can only help hold yourself accountable to what's a mistake and what's not. And so, you know, you're either a person that wants to make it look right or better, or you stop and you say that's good enough.
So for people who just hopped on, these illustrations are going to be used for posters and other things for the Sublime with Rome, Dirty Heads and Friends Summer Tour, presented by the awesome Magical Butter. And this is a concept sketch of what it's all going to look like when all of these pieces are put together as one illustration. In the end, it's all going to come together and look killer.
Out of the three,
what do you like best?
You got the octopus, mushrooms, the little flowers, the magical butter sun. Just be interested to see what everybody's digging the most. I'm sure all the designers at Magical Butter and Sublime and the Dirty Heads are going to have a lot of fun playing with this art. Videos is you see that, you know, every little inch of all these paintings I've created over the years have been done just like this, you know, and filled in all this color by hand, and now these like little paintings exist in the world. Kind of cool.
Ideas do you try out before deciding on a final piece? Sean Watkins wants to know.
Wow. Yeah, it all kind of starts with a real down and dirty sketch, just really rough. And I think it's one of the things I've always been good at is laying out the overall composition and then filling in the ideas that people want to see or I want to see. But yeah, there's usually a stack of paper that goes with all this. All the sketches are in the back room, but yeah, I'll grab real quick.
Here, we're following you.
Yeah, so here's a stack of paper of all these sketches. Just rough ones, tight ones. There's a real rough one.
Okay.
There's the original sketch for that. And there was probably a one before that. There's a tighter one of it. There's the mushrooms. This was an earlier version. Yeah, so that's how it's done. This was the original butter machine, all bubbling butter. That got rejected, so we had to tighten it up. So, yeah, lots.
Show me Ohana Fest stuff.
Alright.
Just briefly, this is just to show what a finished. This is my office, by the way. That's my desk, my carrot juice.
Yeah, so this is the finished one. This is the Ohana Fest. And so This one's pretty rad. And and this is the what it looked like in the end.
So this is the ad map they're using to advertise the concert. Yeah. This based is a, off the art.
This is a blurry printout, but it was just basically trying to fit all the bands in there. Pretty cool. Hope you enjoyed everything. Thanks for watching.
All right, maybe we'll do this again tomorrow. Thanks, everybody. And
see ya.
Do us a favor, if you enjoyed this, would you just share it with your friends? We really want to spread the word and make all this hard work we're doing for you pay off. So, yeah, just spread the word. Share it on your Facebook page. We'd love you for it. Thanks. Ciao.